Noel Johnson plays Andrew Marsh in this mystery serial by David Ellis. Find the Lady. Find the Lady, episode one, in which Andrew Marsh loses a checkbook.
Evening, it's Andrew Marsh.
Yes?
Detective Sergeant Rankin, I'd like a word with you.
I see your warrant card.
I was just going to show it to you. There you are, Mr. Marsh.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. What's this about, Sergeant?
Oh, perhaps it'd be better if I came in, sir. You don't want your neighbours seeing you talking to policemen.
You think they'd guess what you are?
They tell me I look like a typical copper, so if you don't mind.
Come in, Sergeant.
Thanks. Nice flat you've got, Mr. Marsh.
We like it.
Yes. Different to the sort of homes most of our customers have. Oh, do you mind if I sit down?
Please do.
Ah, thanks. Do you know what it's like being on your feet all day, Mr. Marsh?
I can imagine.
Oh, you're one of these lucky blokes that earns his living sitting behind a desk, eh?
I'm on my feet some of the time.
Doing what, Mr. Marsh?
I beg your pardon.
How do you earn your living?
I sell second-hand cars.
Not much of a job, is it?
Why? You're looking for recruits for the police force?
Not right now. I'm not. You didn't buy that in this country, did you?
What?
That oversized, what do you call it, the poof?
As a matter of fact, I bought it in a bazaar in Champollion Street in Cairo. It's made of camel hide and I paid £12 for it. Would you like to see the receipt?
Oh, I'm not interested in the shopping you did in Egypt, Mr. Marsh. When were you there, by the way?
3 years ago.
Where do you do your shopping in London? For instance, if I mentioned Rutland's of Bond Street and Wiley's of Oxford Street, would you know who they are?
I've heard of them.
Mm-hmm. They have this sort of customers who always pay by cheque. You've never used their shops?
Not that I can remember. My wife might have been a customer of theirs.
Might have been, Mr. Mars? Past tense?
From what I've heard about them, they don't put tickets on their goods. You buy first and ask the price later.
That's about it.
At the moment, I have to know what it's going to cost me before I say, wrap it up, I'll take it.
You've got this flat on a lease, haven't you?
Yes, 5 years.
Yes, the rent must be, well now, seeing you're only half an hour from the West End, I'd say, well, 500-600 a year? How do you manage to pay that much, Mr. Marsh?
Sergeant, exactly what are you doing here? Making inquiries about my financial status, finding out about my shopping habits, or just resting your feet?
Could say I'm doing a bit of each, sir. Your wife at home, Mr. Marsh?
No.
Not home from the office yet.
She doesn't work. As a matter of fact, she's at the hairdresser's.
Oh.
Do you think we could get to the point?
Yes, I don't see why not. Well, it's like this. Rutland's and Wiley's and a few more shops like them have been... Well, they've been having second thoughts about being so free and easy on this business of taking cheques. You see, someone's taken advantage of their good nature.
Really?
Yes. Mind you, these ritzy shops are not the only ones who've been taken for mugs. The big department stores have copped it as well. In fact, it's getting a bit out of hand.
What is?
I thought I'd explain that. I'm talking about the dud cheque racket, Mr. Marsh.
Oh, I see.
The Yard have had to set up a special sort of section to deal with it. But let's get one thing straight, though. When I say dud cheque, I don't mean the bouncer. The one that a bloke gives you and then it comes back from your bank marked RD, meaning the bloke's no funds in his account. When I say dud cheque, I mean the villain who's signed it has no bank account at all. He's used a fictitious name and he's given a false address. You with me so far, Mr. Marsh?
Yes, but I don't see why you're giving me this glimpse behind the scenes, fascinating though it is.
You'll see in a minute. See, when these dud cheques get to this special section of the Yard, they keep an eye on numbers, because every now and then they find a bunch of numbers that follow each other. In other words, the cheques all came out of the same book.
Yes?
Right. Well, I'm concerned about one of these books that's just turned up. Now, it's been passed on to us because it was issued by a bank in our manor, the Southeastern. Something wrong, Mr. Marsh?
No.
You looked for a second like you thought you'd sold a car, then the bloke changed his mind.
Oh.
Anyway, as I was saying, we've got these dud cheques that all came out of the same book, and it was issued by the Southeastern. Do you know who it was issued to?
I've no idea.
They issued it to you, Mr. Marsh. Well?
Well, what?
Well, can you tell me how those dud cheques came out of a book that was issued to you?
Someone must have found one I lost.
Oh, you lost a cheque-book?
Yes.
Oh, when?
Oh, about a month or so ago. I'm not sure exactly.
You didn't tell your bank you lost it, Mr. Marsh?
No.
And why not?
Well, I intended to tell them. It must have slipped my mind. I was busy.
Selling second-hand cars?
Trying to sell them.
Oh, I wish I could forget about my cheque-book. But, of course, in our job we have to pay our bills.
So do I. But I'm paid in cash. I've used that.
Mm-hmm. Have you? That fancy piece of furniture over there is a desk, isn't it, Mr. Marsh?
Yes.
Would you mind opening it to see if you can find a piece of writing paper?
All right. Now what?
Do you mind writing the name Derek Brown?
Yeah, Brown with or without an E?
Please yourself, Mr. Marsh.
All right. Yeah. Is that what you want, Sergeant?
That'll do nicely, Mr. Marsh. Brown with an E.
I imagine the type of people who are customers of shops like Wiley's and Ratland's would spell it that way.
And did you imagine they'd spell Derrick, D-E-R-R-I-C-K?
I didn't think about it.
Is that so? Of course, you'll have guessed that Derrick Brown's the name the bloke used when he signed those dud checks I told you about.
Well?
Well, he spelt Derrick, D-E-R-R-I-C-K. I-C-K.
And you think that means something?
Could. Yes, could, Mr. Marsh. You see, that isn't the only way to spell it. Sometimes it's D-E-R-E-K, and then, of course, there's one of those actor chaps that spells it D-E-R-Y-C-K. But you picked the spelling that Chummy used.
Coincidence, Sergeant.
I don't believe in it, Mr. Marsh.
They do exist.
Not in my book. You've lived here just on 4 years, haven't you?
Yes.
Before that, your address was Flat Free, Blenheim House, Princess Gardens.
It was.
When Derek Brown put his address on the back of his dud checks, that's the one he used.
You're saying that I am Derek Brown?
I'm suggesting you could be.
It's more than a suggestion, isn't it? You're convinced I passed those checks.
I have to go on evidence. Look at the evidence again. You forgot to let your bank know you'd lost your checkbook. The dud checks came out of that book. They were signed with a name you can spell two or three ways, but you used the way Chummy used, and D-E-R-R-I-C-K, Brown, with an E, Mr. Marsh. He gave the address where you used to live.
Andrew, what do you think of my Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know you had a visitor.
I won't be long, Joyce.
Good evening, Mrs. Marsh.
Good evening.
I'm Detective Sergeant Rankin. I'm very pleased to meet you.
Detective Sergeant... Andrew, is something wrong?
No, just a slight misunderstanding. I'll explain later.
Oh. Well, I'd better do something about dinner. Excuse me, Sergeant Rankin.
Of course, Mrs. Marsh, of course. You know, Mrs. Marsh looks like she buys her clothes from smart places, like Wiley's and Rutland's. Yes, what they call the sophisticated type, isn't she?
She wouldn't like it if she heard you call her a type. My wife prefers to think of herself as an individualist.
Oh, different from my missus, Mr. Marsh. Oh, she's a type if ever there was one. Still come to that, we both are. She's a typical housewife and I'm a typical copper.
You seem rather proud of the fact.
I am, Mr. Marsh, I am. You know, I bet my wife's cheaper to keep in clothes than yours is.
Are you sympathizing with me?
No, just thinking aloud, Mr. Marsh. You know, all that stuff that Chummy bought with those checks... That would have suited Mrs. Marsh. Oh, by the way, what do you think of the evidence I went over just now?
Very circumstantial. I don't think a jury would convict me.
They might. Still, we have to be sure.
So, I'll be able to have my dinner at home tonight.
Yes, yes, you're lucky. I'll be having mine in the canteen. You ever had anything to eat in a police station, Mr. Marsh?
No.
Well, for your sake, I hope you never have to. Where was this taken?
What?
This photograph, you in uniform.
Courier.
National serviceman?
Yes.
Oh. Second lieutenant as well. Well, that might do you a bit of good.
In what way?
Well, a good army record always goes down well in court. You'll be at home over the weekend if I want to have another word with you.
I work all day tomorrow, but I'll be at home in the evening and on Sunday.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.